Welcome! This video refers to the capability of running optimization studies using response surface models through the optimization tool of ANSA. Morph parameters and an optimization task have been already defined in this model. More details on their creation can be found in the Design of Experiment Study in ANSA and Meta video of our channel. To begin with, it is possible to set up and run an optimization study using a response surface model in order to reach an optimum design based on an objective function. An optimization task has been already defined. It can be accessed from the Tools toolbar, Optimization tool. This contains 5 design variables connected with defined morph parameters, 2 that control the thickness of selected PIDs, a script that performs cell mesh reconstruction, a mass response item along with a responses.txt file which records the mass of the model, and an FE output file. The solver and the post-processing items have been also defined. In addition, a session file has been created in Meta in order to extract the maximum torsion and maximum bending stresses. In the DOE Setup tab, some experiments have been already generated. A DOE study with at least 10 experiments is a prerequisite for training a model, since its experiments are used as a training dataset. In the RSM Setup tab, the creation process is initiated by pressing the New RSM button. In this case, where the optimization is defined in the working directory, only the creaking algorithm is available. However, in case Saving DM is active and the ML toolkit is installed, both machine learning and creaking algorithms are available. The available responses are displayed in the responses step. In this example, all of them are selected, and the name for the RSM group that is to be created is typed. Enter is pressed in order to continue in the confirmation step, where information about the model's training is shown. By pressing the Start button, the training process begins. Once the training is terminated, the predictive entities can be seen, listed under the same group. One or multiple RSMs can be trained in the optimization tool. Finally, the optimization problem can be defined using the key values from the RSMs as design parameters. The new optimization study button is clicked to begin designing the process. A name for the study is typed. The available algorithm is the simulated annealing, and the RSM method is selected. The attributes are left as they are. RSM optimization can run either in a working directory or in DM. In case of DM, conflicts among the existing data may be reported in this step. However, in our case, since there is not a DM connected to the optimization, no conflicts are detected. In the responses step, all the available predictive models are selected to be used as design parameters for the optimization problem. Next, some constraints are added, pressing the plus button. The max stress torsion response is selected and an upper limit of 250 is set. In the same step, the objective function is also defined. In the expression column, the mass measurement is selected and the operator is set to minimize. Continuing, the initial values that are needed from the optimization algorithm are defined. The tool lists automatically a set of values. These values refer to the experiment of the DOE run with the best objective value. In this case, the objective is the minimization of mass and has been specified in the previous tab. It is also possible to edit the shown values. Finally, a review of the optimization study's information is shown. The definition process is finalized by pressing the Finish button. Once the optimization study is defined, it is listed in the Contents area of the Optimizer tab. By clicking on the study, information of it can be seen in the right side of the window. Pressing the Start button, the optimization process is initiated. All data that occur are in the defined working directory and are available to view in the Results tab. New charts can be created pressing the respective button. The correlation chart is selected. Having all design variables and responses checked, OK is pressed. The optimization tool is maximized for a better view. This chart shows the linear relation between two variables measuring from minus 1 to 1. 1 means the two variables are positively correlated. If the value is closer to 0, the variables are uncorrelated. And if the value is minus 1, the variables are negatively correlated. Pearson and Spearman are different correlation types. Finally, an interaction effect plot is added from the new chart drop-down menu. The rear height is selected as a response, the max stress torsion as a factor, and the side height as a moderator. The interaction plot presents how the relation between a response and a factor depends on the value of a second factor or moderator. If the lines are parallel, there is no interaction, while non-parallel lines means there is interaction. Thank you for watching.